Hey friends, hey, I'm back from a Pilates workout and I was listening to the Life Coach School podcast with Brooke Castillo and she was talking about the compounding effect, the compounded effect, right? And it made me think about, especially in January, where we're getting towards the end of the month, a lot of people that have New Year's resolutions may have stopped those, that we just have to start with one thing. It's the one thing that we do on a consistent basis that adds up and changes our lives. And it can be really overwhelming to think about completely changing our diet or completely changing our exercise program or whatever that looks like in your life or your business. But if we go back to those one things, that one thing, and we do that with consistency, you're gonna see changes. It's not gonna happen in the first week. It's not gonna happen maybe even in the first month. But when you look back over that previous year, everything is different. And I think that's a really powerful, cool tool to remember that I do Pilates once a week and that is going to change my body a year from now. It's not that instant gratification. And so much in our society, I think we're after that instant gratification and that's not really there and it's not sustainable, but it's those little things. So what is one thing that you can do with consistency and add that into your life? And that may be one glass of water. Add in one extra glass of water every single day and start there. That may be making a commitment to yourself to do one yoga class a week or one Tai Chi class a week, or maybe that's going for a walk or whatever that looks like, that it doesn't have to be a huge thing. Maybe you clean your home for 15 minutes a day. How different is everything gonna look a year from now? And I love that. Start with the one thing and how that adds up over time and creates these miracles and these changes in your life. And maybe you are doing just one little thing. Maybe you swap out that cookie that you have once a day for something else. And that's not gonna happen just right away, but will add up. I know for me, when I changed my diet and I went gluten, dairy, and sugar free, my face cleared up, my skin cleared up, all of that, but it took time. And I look back 7 years ago, 8 years ago, when I got cancer, when I was really sick, and I look different. My skin looks different. All of that is completely different. So I wanted to encourage you. It was on my heart. I thought that is so profound, right? That we don't have to stress ourselves out. We don't have to feel like we have to change everything all at once, that we can make a commitment to ourselves. And as you get quiet and as you tune inward, maybe even ask yourself, what is that one thing that I can start with? What does that look like for me? And as we do that one thing with consistency, it gets easier and we will see changes. Not right away, but over time with that. And then you can add in another thing. You know, it doesn't have to be all or none. And so many times I think we feel like, oh, I messed up and I just need to start all over. No, love yourself through this process. You're not gonna change anything by hating on yourself. Love yourself through the process. But I loved that idea. And the compound effect, there's actually a book about it too, which I'm gonna have to go and check out and learn more about this because it's fascinating to me. But I love how one small change done consistently can change the dial and change your entire life. It was really powerful for me to hear that message today and thought I would pop on and share in case anybody needed to hear that too. Hope you're having a fantastic January and take that and go with that one big thing, right, that you can do in your life. Oh, so you just found out that your husband's gluten intolerant. Yeah. You know, I actually went to the library and bought Gluten-Free for Dummies. And that's where I started on my journey. And it's those little steps, those little changes. Even with our diet, I think so many times people feel like they have to change everything. There's really about maybe 5 or 6 meals that we tend to rotate regularly. And if you just make those little swaps, it makes it easier to do those things more sustainably versus feeling like you have to completely change your entire diet or your entire life. When you find simple swaps, when you can think of, I can find 6 meals and experiment that tastes really good for my family, it can change everything. So I encourage you on this journey of going gluten-free because it's made such a difference for me. I didn't know that I had celiac until I did genetic testing. That was really powerful of don't feel like you have to overhaul everything, right? But just start with those little things, do your research, and give it about 3 months. Give it about 3 months with these nutritional changes, right? It's like the one thing, it's like that one meal that you had. What if you swapped one breakfast every day? How would that change your life? Give it time. because you're not going to notice the difference the next day or the next day or the next day, but in the next 3 weeks or in the next 3 months, those big differences come. And we are a sum of those daily actions and those habits that we do on a regular basis. All of that really impacts our life. So if you want to change your life, look at your daily habits, look at those little things that you're doing every single day and see if they're helping you and serving you, or if not, where we could swap that out. I hope you guys found this helpful. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and we'll talk again soon. Bye.